The National Union of Journalists of the Philippines mourns the death of an icon of Philippine journalism. The group remembers Teodoro as the staunchest advocate for the best in the profession and the most savage critic of its worst practices. It also vows to continue Teodoro's legacy of wielding the pen in the service of the people. Carlos Conde of Human Rights Watch, meanwhile, says the Philippine media landscape won't be the same without Teodoro. Well, veteran journalist Luis Teodoro has passed away. He was 81 years old. The UP College of Mass Communication announced the news on social media. It said Teodoro, who served as dean from 1994 to 2000, was pivotal in fostering academic excellence, upholding integrity in the practice of media, and defending the freedoms of the press, speech, and assembly. Teodoro was the founding chairperson of Alter Media, a network of media outfits, institutions, and individuals. He was also known for his political commentaries. The Public Works Department has announced a bridge project that will connect Cavite and Bataan. Katrina Domingo now joins us with details. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. The construction of the 175 billion peso bridge that will connect Bataan and Cavite has been accelerated by the latter part of this year. That's according to DPWH Secretary Manuel Bonoan. If we recall, that project was slated to start construction by next year in 2024. But Bonoan says it's now ready to begin by the end of 2023, particularly because the government is almost done with its design engineering, which is already at 70%. That means that the only thing that's left for the government to do is to procure civil works materials needed to construct this bridge that is expected to cut travel time between Manila and Bataan to 2 hours from the original 5-hour trip. Bonoan says that it has been the priority of the DPWH to construct this bridge, particularly because the growth corridors are in the southern part of Metro Manila as well as the northern part of Metro Manila. He says this project will give the capital city or the capital region have better access to these emerging growth areas. He says no less than the Asian Development Bank has indicated that the economic return of this bridge will be more than 25% of the project cost. Now, the 32-kilometer bridge is expected to be completed in 5 years. That's as the DPWH pushes to complete several high-ticket or big-ticket projects before the term of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. ends. This bridge is part of some 70,000 major and minor infrastructure projects, both in the national and local level, that the DPWH is planning to begin by this year. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Katrina Domingo, there joining us live. Thanks, Kat.